What's up out there, everybody? It's Friday, beautiful day. Gym closes early on Fridays. We finish our week with an amazing Jailhouse Friday workout with our college crew. We'll blow the doors off the gym from, you know, 1 to 3, and then out we go. Get to go home, get my little guy early today, have some epic daddy time, and do some cool shit. So today, you know, or this week rather, I've been kind of talking a little bit about marketing. You know, I went on a rant one day, talked about email marketing yesterday. And a lot of people always ask me, you know, what's the starting point? Like, how do I get started with my marketing? And I always say, you know, kind of know thyself, right? And the most important thing for your marketing is kind of just knowing who you are and who you want to be, who you want to work with, you know, what kind of brand you want to be known for, you know, and things like that. And, you know, and how you're going to portray your image, right, is important. So having a brand strategy and knowing who you are and who you want to work with are super critical before you even get started with marketing. So before you start wasting time, energy, and or money on marketing, make sure you do an introspective look and look at yourself, right? So let's talk a little bit about my story, right? So I knew I wanted to work with athletes at a very young age. I was fortunate enough that my next door neighbor growing up was a physical therapist and knew somebody who was training people and was looking for somebody. And a lot of the people that he were training had athletes, and that's where he wanted me to come in. He knew I was an athlete, knew I was into training and performance and stuff like that. And he was like, you know, you can train. I have some kids that want to do like sports performance. So I was like, perfect. So we did that. And then I had an ex-girlfriend that was like, you know, right out of high school almost. And then I had a girlfriend at the time whose little brother was playing hockey, an ex-girlfriend, and her little brother was playing hockey, and my mom wound up running into her in the shop, right, and got to talking about what I was doing, and they were like, hey, you know, he's playing, him and his friends are playing hockey at a Catholic school right by where I live now, Bergen Catholic, and they were like, you know, I was like, oh, you know, do you think Joe could train them? And I was like, yeah, sure, you know, whatever. So my mom hooked it up, and mom sold me my first real group of athletes, you know what I mean? And that was it. Kind of the rest is history. I got that bug. I knew what I wanted to do. I was really excited about that. I really enjoyed training. You know, I'd go back to school in the fall. I'd come home in the summer and train people. And then I started training people at school. And I was, for about 10 years, from 19 to like 30, right, until I opened up my gym when I was like 29, right, in 06, the only thing that I consumed was performance. The only thing that I focused on was performance. The only thing that I thought about was performance. And in particular, youth performance, youth athletic development. I worked at a bunch of other gyms, and they were doing like a lot of just speed classes and things like that. And back in that time, it was like, you know, in 90, 95, there was nobody, right? It was like, you know, Bill Parisi was just getting his thing going, right? And, you know, Mike Boyle's always been around. There's always been some performance guys and things like that, but like it wasn't like it is now. There was some speed schools and things like that. Parisi bought that speed school thing. And I was like, well, that's great, and it's really, you know, awesome thing that he's doing, but I wanted to do strength and conditioning. I was into Westside Barbell at the time. I was into, like, you know, old school bodybuilding. I was into Mike Mentzer's, you know, heavy duty and all that type of stuff. I was a huge, huge fan. Like, I would say, like, my favorite bodybuilder of the 90s was Dorian Yates, and he was a disciple of heavy duty, and Mike Mentzer was, like, his mentor. So, I read everything that Dorian put out. I used to write him letters personally and stuff like that, you know. So I was real into that type of training and believed that it had a place in sports performance, even for kids. And, you know, people thought I was crazy. You know, like, you're going to hurt kids. Kids are going to, you know, you're going to stunt their growth. Kids don't need to lift weights. My son wants to get fast. He needs to run. I'm like, no. Your son's weak as shit. He needs to lift, right? Even though he's only 12. I'm like, well, he's too young to lift weights. I'm like, we're not lifting 400-pound weights, you dumbasses, right? You know, I mean, we're talking about doing push-ups and squats. You need resistance training, right? And stuff like that. So I was kind of, you know, let's call it an outlier, you know what I mean? Where, like, everybody was, you know, afraid of weights and going through this functional training kick that was going through the industry, and everybody was doing speed schools and standing on standing on one foot, you know, doing a bandit row, right? And before they ever even had any functional strength to begin with. So I'm like, no, what's more functional than squats, deadlifts, bench presses, and pull-ups? Nothing. Zero. Push-ups, that's it. Those five exercises, you could work a kid for about 5 years and never change, you know, just change some rep sets and volume and load, and you're good, right? Most kids don't need as much variation because they got more testosterone than five of us put together at my age, at least now, right? So that was kind of where I started. So I had a really good focus of where I wanted to do. My first company I started was called Sport Dynamics, right? So I had my little business cards that I made myself. I had some trifold folders that I made myself, right? And that was like, that was what will be, what was going to be, what is now Varsity House 20 years later. And you know, a lot of the same training philosophy, a lot of the same, you know, verbiage we used for years. And now we've obviously grown up and changed a lot of things and made things a lot more professional and stuff like that. But our mission to help young athletes, their families, and the community that they live in is still today the same mission, right? We believe that all athletes, no matter their age, size, or ability, can perform better on the field by developing themselves physically off of the field. And that mantra still exists in our gym today, and that's on our marketing materials and things like that, and that's what we believe in. And that started when I was 19 years old. So having knowing yourself and knowing what you want to do, what makes you, I didn't want to be training, you know, older population. I didn't want to be training, you know, people. Now we have a huge gym with a lot of other stuff going on, but only because I was able to, you know, in a sense, label myself as being the go-to guy in our community for sports performance, right? So we did that for years. And then, you know, and as you evolve, there's a couple other things that, you know, as you grow as a business, and now with information being so readily available, it's a lot easier to see what other people are doing and the professionalism that other, you know, top level gyms and pros are putting out. So like, you need to know yourself, right? Who do you want to work with? What type of business do you be? What type of brand do you want? Do you want to be edgy and over the top like Mark Fisher Fitness and the Dog Pound? Or do you want to be like super techie science like a John Russin or an Eric Cressy, right? Things like that. Is that your niche? You know, is it kids like us, families and sports performance, right? Or is it adult population? Do you want to be the, you know, the best, you know, group fitness, small group fitness, private training boutique studio in the area, whatever it might be. Hey, no, that's my boys. And Power Pro Power Washing. And, you know, look around the community. Also, you know, one of the most important things in all of business is having location and a unique position in the industry, right? So what do you do that's different than the other people in your area, right? So when I came into my area where our gym is, there was nobody, zero, doing sports performance, and there's still nobody. There might be a couple pretenders, but there's still basically nobody doing real sports performance with kids. I mean, yesterday we had over 150 athletes in the gym. So, you know, nobody's doing sports performance like we're doing. Nobody's specifically catering to youth athletes and developing kids from 11 all the way through high school, all the way through college, and then some to the pros, right? You know, we have taken kids literally from 7th grade through to the pros, and not a lot of other places can say that, right? You know, so that was our niche, and that we only did that. And for years, we only trained athletes. You know, for 5 years, we didn't touch an adult. We said no to lots of them, right? Because we just wanted to, let's just focus on getting great at one thing, okay? Have a mission statement. Have your core values set. You have a mission and core values, right? What do you stand for? What are the ideological backbone of your business? Hungry, humble, and committed. Our mission is to facilitate greatness, to give our clients the best hour of the day through world-class coaching, atmosphere, and consistency and accountability, right? That's our mission, right? We want to provide people with the tools to better themselves physically, whether it's on the field of play or in the field of life, right? So things like that, right? Having those things written out, bannered up in your gym, written out in paper, your entire staff needs to know it, the community needs to know it, super important, right? You know, having, you know, some idea of the direction of your company, goals, where do you want to go? Do you want to have multiple gyms? Do you want to just be the best guru? Do you want to be an online person, right? Those things are super important because that dictates the direction of your marketing. Who are you speaking to, right? If I'm trying to drive traffic to a local gym, that's extremely different than from trying to sell products online to other fit pros and or have people buy online products or online training programs to use themselves. So Know thyself. That's one of the most important things. Create a unique position in the industry and separate yourself from the competition.